So while we're waiting for cable news to change some of its typical ways of focusing on division in politics, while we're waiting on social media, while we're waiting on the donors to reward working together rather than going to the extremes, what can people do? What can individuals do you think?
Well, I think one thing is to engage across lines of political difference in a respectful way, you know, try to run towards the fire rather than away from it, you know, have conversations with your socialist or Tea Party supporting uncle. It's always the uncles, I don't know why. But whoever that person is in your family or your neighborhood, you know, like engage with them respectfully and try to give them that interaction that they're not getting now, you know, where they see that you could disagree with somebody and it could still be a respectful conversation.
Willer and others were heartened by the 2022 midterm results, in which many Republican candidates who promoted election conspiracies lost their races.
2024 is the final battle. That's going to be the big one.
And yet, with former President Donald Trump, who continues to deny his own loss in 2020, looking like the strongest contender for the Republican nomination in 2024, Willer says we are not out of the woods yet.
I think it's very possible it's going to get even worse before it gets better. We haven't reached that point, you know, where powerful interests on the left and right, party leaders, high-level donors have realized, oh, we actually should be working together to work on this Pandora's box that we've opened up. We haven't gotten there yet, and that might be the way that it's most realistically going to happen, is that the harms of political division destabilizing our society or economy, that unites powerful interests to take some sort of action together. But in the near term, all we have is us, and you can never tell what can happen from the results of collective action.